Hey YouTube, it's me, Miss Wanda. Hope you guys are doing well. Anyway, I just came on today to say, what the hell are we doing, y'all? What are we doing? Now, this is gonna be a grown woman's video. So we're on some grown woman shit right about now. YouTube, for the most of us, you know, I've been on YouTube a long time. Still, you know, never really took off big or anything like that. And I'm okay with that. You know, I come on just bored and stuff. It's like a hobby to me. I enjoy interacting with y'all in y'all chat rooms. As you know, I go into most chat rooms. I really do, you know. And even frenemies and friends and enemies chat rooms. So I go in everybody's spaces because I really don't have a problem with many people, you know. As in life, we have disagreements. You know, I don't agree with everybody and their content. And most of the time, you know, if I'm rocking with y'all talking about a message that I resonate with, I listen, I enjoy it. You know, sometimes I talk my shit, sometimes I'm peaceful and happy, whatever the situation is. And if there's something that is really, really off that doesn't resonate me, you know, I exit from the conversation and I go somewhere else. And then I come back. And so I think I'm speaking for a lot of people in the space. You know, you have some demons and imps in this damn space that like to conjure up shit and to dwell in it like bottom dwellers and bottom feeders. And really, this is my song. Anyway, so they're like bottom dwellers and bottom feeders. And after a while, I feel dirty and toxic and I move away. Now, the thing that's happening to Black woman's fear, or the woman's fear, and Nyla is very shocking to me, and so many others. And I've been asked, you know, to mind my business. But unfortunately, because it's brought out into the open space, is everybody's business now. And so I don't like it. I don't like it at all. I really don't. Now, the part that is not my business, as far as I guess y'all was friends outside of YouTube or whatever, and now y'all broke apart, but because the information is brought online, it's putting a lot of us like at a standstill, basically, because it's like, okay, well, we're hearing one side of the story and the other side of the story. And for many of us, you guys have not personally have done anything to us. So we don't really have any reason to dislike a person just because someone is coming out saying that they did A, B, C, or D. Unless like some charge has been brought out or some really detrimental harm has been done to someone. For a lot of us, you know, we're bored and shit. We come online. It's a form of entertainment, right? And so we listen, we vibe with y'all, get something out of it. Sometimes, you know, we're in a negative space where we like the bullshit, you know. And truth as it's told, you know, there's some dysfunctionality in myself too. That's why I gravitate to some of the bullshit. But it comes a time when, you know, after a while, it gets to the point to where it's really heavy. You know, it's heavy and it hurts people. You know, just like I heard about Brother Moses crying and stuff like that. And for you people out there to say, well, it's just online. Why is it not affecting you a certain way? It does. It really, it affects us all. you know, because a lot of us, we spend the majority of our free time on YouTube. And maybe this is a wake-up call for all of us to, I don't know, like right now I'm watching Game of Thrones, to break off and to do something else, you know. But yeah, it's kind of sort of sounding like a lot of high school shit to me, to be honest with you. And just be very careful what you say, because, you know, if you don't truly have the receipts to back up what you're saying, it hurts people. It hurts people. It's bringing more people into the mix. And, you know, I just don't understand it. I don't. And it's letting me to believe that people online truly don't have real relationships, okay? Because if you have real relationships, it's just not that easy to disclose it in front of the world or in front of an audience, you know, unless you're truly trying to hurt that person. And, you know, I mean, I'm hearing shit about homelessness, crackhead mamas and daddies, you know, and just, I mean, we supposed to be Black people. Most, not all, but a lot of Black people have been affected by the crack epidemic, and it hits close to home. You know, I might be here, and I try not to really put on a facade about who I am. I mean, I think I am somewhat private because I know the toxicity of this space, and, you know, in working through life circumstances and problems and different things like that, to have somebody throw that shit up in your face can be like a dagger. And it'll potentially put you in a mental space that you don't really necessarily want to go. So on one end, yes, I want to share and say, hey, you know, in a positive sense of, you can come back from whatever, you know. And I'm speaking of a person who was homeless. I'm speaking of a person who was abused. I'm speaking of a person who did have a parent that was on crack cocaine and that recovered. And I'm speaking of a person that, in spite of all of that, has accomplished a lot in her life, right? So I just hope and pray that soon we can get past this shit and get back to the content, whatever it is that you guys want to put out, that's not really dragging someone else per se. You know, do what you do, boo. I mean, if that's really your thing, I have to just get to the point where, okay, I'm not gonna listen to it. That's them. I'm not going to listen to it. I'm just going to listen to content, you know, that's funny. If you want to, you know, dragging sometimes or whatever, there's a difference between roasting and just trying to destroy someone's life. And so, you know, like I said before, I have to get to that point in my life where, okay, you know, whatever the sensationalism is to hear the shit, I can't have that in my world, in my space, you know. And truly, if you are in a domestic violence situation, whoever you are, please reach out for help. If you are in a situation where you're homeless, as a community, we should come together to help people. And I know some of y'all say, well, yeah, we did try to do this and that, and they hurt us. And, you know, use wisdom in this space. Take it as online satire. You know, we all, you know, I heard something said about, okay, well, you know, this person is portraying to be something that they're not. Okay, let's talk about that. Personally, I don't know too many women that I mean, of course, right now what you see is what you get. This is me. There's no filter or anything like that, but some of my pictures are filtered. I put a light filter on, you know, not to drastically change who I am, but I do. And most Instagram models and different people like that, they use lighting, makeup, accessories to present themselves in a light that they are truly not in, right? So, and I mean, I may come on here, like, we all have problems, issues, and shit. We all do. I have things that I'm going through, you know. I've been married for 20 years. My husband and I, we have issues. Everybody I know have issues. There is no perfect person online. And you are highly deceived to put a person in a situation to think, okay, this person doesn't argue, or that person doesn't do that, or they don't have situations and issues, or, you know, different things like that, you know. We all have various things that we are dealing with in life, guys. And we have babies watching us. Ladies, we have babies watching. I mean, when I say babies, I mean young women that are watching us, you know. If someone is stealing from you to the point to where it's thousands of dollars, please take them to court. Get your money back. You know, if y'all doing some illegal shit, that's a different thing. I don't know what you're doing. But I want to be able to rock with everyone in this space. Meaning, you know, if you got some dope ass content, I don't want to have to choose, okay, well, because you beefing with that person and I like this person over here because they haven't done anything to me, you know? As a supporter and a subscriber, I should be able to support all of y'all, right? I shouldn't have to choose between you and this person, you know, like I said, unless, you know, there's some, I don't know, criminal activity going on to the point to where there is concrete police reports of abuse of somebody being hurt or dogged out to the point to where, you know, of course, I don't want to have anything to do with people like that. But if you guys are close and y'all deal with each other offline and y'all have a falling out, that part is really none of our business. That part is not none of our business. You know, that's what happened between y'all. You know, I'm sorry that it happened to you. If what you're saying is true, really did happen. But I personally don't have the time or the energy to really divulge and you know, look into every receipt or this, that, and the other. And people, I just don't, you know. And it's toxic. Right now, I just posted the other day, another pregnant black woman was found murdered. Right? And nobody is really looking into it. There's no suspects. It'll probably end up being a closed case. This kind of shit devalues us as a whole. You know, meaning if we're like in my household, if we have a falling out or something, I'm not going to go take it to work. I'm not going to take it to this place. I'm not going to share it with everybody. And, you know, and if that's you and that's what you want, you say, well, okay, I'm warning people. Okay, we've been warned. We know not to have business deals with people online. Thank you. Thank you for sharing that with us. And I've taken heed to it. Don't, you know, don't do like monetary business dealings. Don't allow yourself to get very close to people online. Unfortunately, you can't share fucking pictures. You can't share information. You can't, you know, have a friend like that online because, you know, if you fall out or if they dislike you, that person may decide to hurt you and your brand. And another thing, okay, we all have our professions, right? for a lot of people, this YouTube thing, for me, it's just a hobby, right? I don't need it for money or anything like that. I mean, I hear the money is good, but if I ever took off and had a whole lot, a large following or whatever, and made a whole lot of money on YouTube, then it would be my business, right? So this hurts people's brand and their business, you know. And I don't know what the goal is. I really don't. I don't know what y'all goal is, but I will say that my goal on YouTube right now is just to have fun, to shoot the shit, to de-stress, you know, to listen. I mean, so many of y'all are so fucking talented. I enjoy it so much. You know, I would prefer to go online and watch TV. And y'all, I mean, y'all be talking about some dope things, interesting things. You know, y'all make me laugh. Sometimes y'all get on my nerves. I get angry. Even with me going into the Manosphere space, like basically Obsidian's channel. To me, he's funny as hell, right? And I like talking my shit. So I go in there and talk my shit. And y'all let me for whatever reasons. And I thank you for that. Thank you for allowing me to be who I am, to express myself. Nyla has always been dope to me since day one. You know, her content has evolved. You know, some of the things, like I said, I don't agree with, and then I turn off, right? Cynthia's, she's evolved with me too. You know, there in the beginning, I didn't care for her. Now I'm starting to like her. I'm starting to see a lot of shit she said is true. Okay, some of the things she says, like aborting back babies, I can never get with that. Never. But that's her content. And when she started talking about that shit, I know how to cut that shit off. Okay, and then I come back when she's talking about something I can resonate with, right? That's just being a grown-ass woman. Now, y'all said some really disparaging things. And I just don't, like I said, as Black people, we got to do better, y'all. We have to treat each other kind. We have to do better. Now, if y'all want to drag and fight and do this, that, and the other, that's your prerogative. But I represent those of us who like drama, but not that much. You know, when it comes down to where you see that people could potentially really be hurt behind this, I don't like that. And if that's what happened to you in the situation to where you feel that you need to come out and say things, you know, I'm sorry that that happened to you. But, you know, can we get to the dope, back to the dope shit again? Can we get back, please, to the growing, to helping one another, or if not helping, with just the entertainment shit? Can we get back to that, please? Anyway, that's my public service announcement. I hope you guys have a wonderful, truly blessed, what is today? Friday. Okay? So, I'm out, y'all. Bye.